Can you imagine, bro, when you put the ink in an actual groove, eh?
Yeah. Yeah. Because traditionally, the lines were actually grooves, and that was actually solid black. Well, it looked blue, but the whole thing was coloured in solid. And the grooves that you saw, the highlights, which gives it the lines. So that's the ultimate look we've been looking at. How's it feeling, bro?
I can feel the subtlety in the blade. It's each.
It's a lot harder than a machine.
What's this blade made out of?
This is made out of toro. Is that enough footage?
Okay, bring him just a little wine shot.
Yeah.
Tell me if you can get trouble with it. Okay, alright. Dude, what was going through your mind while what was going on?
I felt like I was getting a little bit closer to the truth. And that there's all these massive contradictions occurring around me. For example, I'm lying on a piece of plastic from the Wharewhare, and on top of that is something from our forebears, our whariki. And even though they're like, they contradict each other, they need to both be there for it to be real. And I was getting the same feeling from the sounds of the birds and the cars, and how if you didn't have those two things there, it would be false. And it's kind of struck me that that contradiction is what's required for it to be real. Before that, you relate to all the aspects of kiri, and you realise that the whole thing is kiri. On the rima over there, the majesty of that, the divine artistry on the kiri of the rima, and how that's got to be connected to what's going on over here. And like I said, the skin of heaven itself, wrapped around mum's body, like my skin is wrapped around me.